Look, I risk alienating my P1s by saying anything negative about Sarah Palin, so I won't say anything. Are you crazy? Are you out of your damn minds? She reminds me of a country western singer with the aw shucks pretending to be a president. What are you people, nuts? Yes, she says all the right things. Yes, she's a nice lady and her heart's in the right place. But you can see what happens when you have somebody who's unqualified step into the presidency because the people got emotional. Please don't do this to us, I say to myself. If the Republicans commit suicide with her, I quite don't know what I'm going to do. I'll tell you this, I'm not moving to New Zealand. That I can guarantee you. She's like Dolly Parton in her early days. Play a little country and western so they know what I'm talking about. I think we're going to mix Dolly Parton with... Yeah, that's like a Sarah... I could see that on the stage with Sarah Palin. Am I wrong? Guys, am I wrong? I'm not wrong. There goes the P1s. They're mad at me again. So when I first attacked Bush, they didn't know what to do. That was the end of the show for about 3 days, till they came to their senses. I was right. You were wrong. Are you people nuts? Sarah Palin, president? I mean, you want Obama a second term? Go ahead. Make his day.
Saturday. For all things news and talk radio, visit trncentral.com.
I don't want any American to ever close the door in their personal or their professional lives and put themselves in a box and say, heck yeah, I'm going to do that, or no way, I'm not going to do that, when we don't know what the future holds.
A mama grizzly rises up in me hearing things like that. You know, here again, cool, fine, come attack me. But when you make a suggestion like that certainly attacks
a kid. No, no, if you want Obama for a second term, just make sure that Palin is the Republican nominee. That's all. I didn't say she's bad. I didn't say her heart's not in the right place. I just know more about the American electorate than you do. And I know more about it than the stupid Republican Party does. And I am telling you that if they make that idiotic mistake of pushing her as their lead candidate, over, Obama will get a second term no matter how bad his presidency has been. That's my opinion. It's one man's opinion. Doesn't mean I don't agree with her politically. It doesn't mean I think she's a bad person. She's not electable as president. She does not have the, well, I don't want to use a word that was popular 8 years ago, gravitas. You want to use that one? He doesn't either. That doesn't mean that she's not the right person. We need a businessman. We need someone with guts, preferably someone who served in the military. That means we have nobody. And please don't tell me about Mr. Brown. God, please. I warned you, don't Obama-size these guys. You know, be a realist like I am. It's too early already to talk about it. We got the midterm elections to worry about before we get on to that, but it's everywhere you turn. The Tea Party convention was last Saturday. They had 400 people. I had 2,000 people at every event I've ever run. 1,500 to 2,000 people, I pack an auditorium, and people pay for it. It's not for free. I don't have a handlebar mustache, you know what I'm saying, with a Bowie knife to get them in there at the door. What are you talking about, 400 people? That's all that came to the Tea Party convention? They ran it like, oh, big deal. Great, I'm glad. And they charged $500 a piece? That's their right. They wanted to pay $500 a piece, it's their business. They wanted to pay $5,000 a piece, it's their business. What are liberals complaining about? The reason they were complaining about is that they get the illegals in there and the other deadbeats who have nothing to do, they get them in there for nothing. So they hear that they get $500 a head. They went crazy. Oh, can't we tax this somehow? Therefore, I will go to the callers. Daniel in New York on WOR. Go ahead, please.
Michael, I respectfully disagree with you. Sarah Palin is the only one that I've seen in the past year with guts. She's patriotic. She's passionate. I mean, we need something to believe in, and she's every place she goes, they've been trying to knock her down. She's like a David against Goliath. Please enlighten me.
She's unelectable. She has too many negatives to win the presidency. The people themselves can easily be told she does not have the experience, nor the history of experience, nor the intellectual depth to be president.
You think she's less intelligent and less than what Obama is? I mean, this man is an...
Well, you see, again, you're not listening to me. We already have a training wheel president. We don't need another one. Don't you think we need somebody who has some experience in the U.S. Senate, for example? Somebody who knows how the laws of the land are made and unmade, instead of another rank beginner who's going to try to come in and do it her way? In other words, Obama came in with the Chicago style, and it has not worked for him. Thank God, by the way. Thank God that, that Rahm Emanuel played Chicago politics and it backfired on them. But we don't need another rank amateur coming into the White House.
Okay, Mike. Thank you. God bless you.
All right, so they're mad at me now. What are you going to do? You know, look, it's my opinion. What do you want me to do? Goose step Sieg Heil here? Because already they're populist, already I'm supposed to. I say take an experienced conservative senator. Are there any? Sure there are. Shelby, Alabama, Cornyn, Texas, Inhofe, Oklahoma, Jeff Sessions from Alabama. Any one of those senators would be a better choice than Sarah Palin, and they're electable. You take a guy like Mr. Inhofe, this guy on his own stood up to the whole world of liars in the global warming fraud. Over and over again, this man did the right thing for the American people and for the future of America. So as I say, you know, there are other choices. Just because you haven't heard their names mentioned, it doesn't mean they're not going to be interested in running. So don't assume that she's the only possible person to run against Obama in term two. And don't for the minute think he's not going to run again. No matter how bad things look for him right now, he's far from finished. It's only year one. He's got 3 years to go to move to the center. He's got 3 years to go to mend fences with all those he's alienated. And believe me, he's not stupid. So don't start counting the guy out yet. And you got to run a candidate against him who is very experienced. I know what I'm talking about, whether you agree. Bakersfield, California. Ralph, what's on your mind, Ralph?
Dr. Mighty Michael Savage. It's a privilege, sir. The stars have aligned.
So what do you think about Palin?
Well, you know, I think that she has the belief system and the ability to run the country from that conservative platform. I think she gets what made this country great, but I don't think she's electable. I'm afraid to say that they would paint her as a dummy, leaving her governorship and just the whole thing, writing these things on her palm, her notes on her.
Yeah, where did that come from? What is she, like a stupid student wrote the answers on her hand? Is that true?
Yeah, it's true. They zoomed in on it on Channel 30.
My God. Yeah, I heard of it. So she was giving a speech at the Tea Party thing, and she had to look at her hand like a student who didn't remember the answers?
Exactly.
My God. Well, what would you say is worse, using a teleprompter or using a note on your hand?
I think she had to use both.
You know, look, if guys can't have a discussion like this, you know, what am I, a member of the Communist Party USA where I'm not allowed to agree, I'm not allowed to disagree with the conservative movement? What, are you kidding me? I founded the conservative movement in America. I mean, who was at the helm of me for 15 years? Me. So people should respect the fact that at my age and with 15 years in the business, I have a right to tell you what I think. I don't care whether it offends you. I offend liberals every day. Why can't I offend the knee-jerk conservatives?
Absolutely, Michael.
Thank you. Let's hear it for that. You know, we hear the phrase knee-jerk liberal. Fine, we know what that means. Did you ever hear the phrase knee-jerk conservative? Well, you have if you listen to this show. A knee-jerk conservative, when they hear the word elitist already, they think the person's telling them the truth. All right, we can go on. We don't have to talk about that. 1-800-449. You're not worried about Iran. You're worried instead about obesity. Did you hear Michelle Obama? What is the woman? It's like the two of them. What world do they live in? Play the Michelle Obama. The greatest threat to our children is obesity. And you ever hear anything like this? Oreo is a bigger threat than a nuclear bomb.
We're all here today because we care deeply about the health and well-being of not just these kids up here, but for all kids like them all across the country. And clearly we're determined to finally take on one of the most serious threats to their future. And that's the epidemic of childhood obesity in America today.
I'm sorry. So you've heard of the Twinkie defense. This is the Twinkie threat from Michelle Obama. That it's those nasty Twinkies that the Islamo-fascists are going to drop from a missile. They're going to fire a missile in from Iran, and it's going to drop Twinkies all over the inner city, and it's going to destroy children across America. Are they kidding me? That's the most serious threat, is a missile with incoming Twinkies. God, how does this happen? How could I live in a country that's so superficial? And by, you want to talk about a really sensitive issue? I can wager a bet that most women, even conservative women, will not vote for Sarah Palin. They prefer a conservative man. They don't have faith in her.
Well, I loved her before when she was actually coming from the heart. She, everything, like you said, she might as well have a teleprompter in front of her.
She does have a teleprompter. It's another one of these doofus advisors who are telling us, say this, say that. We did all sorts of focus groups, use these hot words. Here are hot button words like elitists in Washington. Ooh, we never heard that one before. I've not heard an original thought come out of her mouth yet.
I'll tell you.
Pardon me, but I'm looking for an American original. I don't think she's it.
Not it. You're one.
No, I want a Republican with experience. Somebody who knows how the laws of the land are made and broken. Somebody who can shop a bill through Congress and really get it done. It's one thing to say something. It's another thing to get it done. As you can see with Obama, he says a lot and he can't get it done. Thank God. That's because they're using Chicago tactics where it does not work, which is in the Senate, which is a very, very different situation. I'll be right back.